Hi everyone, it's the Hobby Dabbler. Today I'm going to work on the page that I started in the fabric dye tutorial. I just have a piece of watercolor paper, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my homemade color washes, and I'm going to hit it with some more color in the spots that I want. So here's peach. I'm trying to keep the colors kind of on each end. And some yellow. Oh, you know what? That was too much yellow. That's okay. We can fix it. So peach and yellow. I'm gonna go in with a bit of not green. A bit of my raspberry color. I'm gonna try to tone that yellow down. There we go. Now I'm going to take some water and give it a good soak to move the colors around some more. Okay. So that's kind of nice. Okay, now I gotta dry it, so I'll be back in a sec. Okay, that's all dry. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some white gesso and I'm gonna go in the middle here. I kind of wanted the colors to stay more separate. So I'm just gonna use my finger to kind of blend in a bit of white gesso in the middle here. I just wanted it a little bit separate. Tone that down a bit. Okay. Now I'm going to take some dark purple and blue ink paint. And I'm going to take my trusty old toilet paper roll and I'm gonna make some circles on there. So I'll start off with the dark purple. Put one here. There. Not the best circle, but that's okay. It's a different shape. Put one here. Now I'm gonna take this piece of lace that I've kind of balled up and I'm gonna pounce some color on in the same dark purple behind it. And I'm actually gonna spread these circles out a bit. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some used tea bags that I've cut in half and I'm just going to add some of that in. tear it kind of in a different shape. I'm going to put one here and one over here. So I'll glue that on with gel medium. And I'm doing that because I think it will add some interesting texture to the page. And a bit of brown. There's the other. Now I think I'll take my ruler and some chalk ink wet wipe glass markers. And I'm gonna do some lines. Just a few. Nothing fancy. On each end. That. And I think I'll do a few going the other way as well. But for this one, I'm going to use an orange. Just have to get my marker primed. Okay. I'm just going to put a few going the other way as well. There we go. And I'm going to take a green marker. And I'm kind of gonna color the tea bags in a bit, so that they have a bit of green on them. Okay. And I'm also going to put a ring inside my circles of the green. Now I'm going to hit it again with the peach. I think I need a bit more peach on this side. Okay, now I think I need to add a little bit more blue back in. Blue or purple. So I'm going to take some bubble wrap, and I'm gonna add a few areas of bubble wrap. to bring in the blue again. So that's all right. Now what? I think I'll take more of that blue and go inside the circles a bit as well. A little over top of the green. Now I'm going to take some of these stamps and add a few stamp elements with my black archival ink. So we'll see how that turns out. I kind of like this one. This one can kind of follow the same lines. There we go. And then let's do some speckles on top of some of this. And then we have these funky little, I'm not sure what to call them, targets almost. And what I'm gonna do with that is I'm gonna take some white Versamark ink. And I'm gonna stamp those here. One of them didn't take. And stamp it here. There we go. And I'm gonna take my white ink and I'm just gonna spread some over here. I feel like that needed a bit of toning down. Also, okay, I'm not loving the tea bags I put on. So, I'm gonna give it a quick dry. Okay. Now I'm gonna take a blue Heroic paint pen. And I'm gonna make a spirally thing over top of it. If my pen would cooperate. I find these pens, they started off really good and now every time I go to use them, they're a pain in the butt. They just don't seem to want to come out nice. There we go. That blended it in better. Okay. I kind of like it the way it is now. I just need a sentiment. So, let's go to our Tim Holtz ideology book. And let's find one. Let's put this one. It's always the small pieces that make the big picture. So I'll give that a snip. And I'll put it kinda to the right. It's always the small pieces that make the big picture. And those seem blaringly white to me. So I'm gonna take a black marker and go around them. Here we go. That makes it fit in better. Okay, so that started with Rit fabric dye, and this is what it ended up as. I hope you enjoyed watching and maybe learned a few things. So thanks so much, and please don't forget to subscribe. Okay, bye, thanks.